All right, I'm Nick. First thing in the morning, back out at the lake. Looks gorgeous out here today. Temperatures dropped a little bit. Feels wonderful. I love it, okay? Today, we'll take a few minutes. I have the 120 PDL here. I'm going to talk to you guys about this flexible locking knob for your drive system. It will work with all the PDL kayaks and the 106 Minn Kota. Brought it out here yesterday, did some more testing. We've sent out a few. We had a few on the website that went out to people for extra testing to see if we needed to change anything. Made a slight adjustment, and now I want to show you guys, okay? It'll be on the website. It is ready to order, fully functional, all that good stuff. If you do order it and it doesn't ship for 1, 2, 3 days, there's going to be a lot of orders for it, okay? There were a lot of orders for it initially. We just wanted to make an adjustment to make it a little bit better. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to remove the old one, which is real easy. Now, when you bought your kayak, it came with a tackle box that had an Allen wrench in it. This is not that one. It's a little bit shorter. But this lets you tighten these down, tighten that one down, and remove these if they break. So we're just going to loosen that up. It'll come right off of there. Very, very easy. Be careful. You don't need to lose that. But it comes with a bolt. You're going to reuse that. It also has a washer installed. Now, you're not going to need that, so set it to the side. Save it in case you need some other time. The flexible knob, don't mind that N, that was just a little label for me. It comes with two screws right here that can be adjusted. Now, you guys are familiar with this. I'm sure you guys have seen it. Sometimes the seal, come back over here, the seal on this drive unit gets a little compressed, and then maybe you have a little wiggle, and you can use these to tighten that down to adjust how high this sits or how much pressure, okay? Nothing to it, very, very simple. This bolt just goes through there. You're just gonna push it in place, and then you can just start it by spinning it. Tighten it down with your wrench. Now remember, this system, that bolt actually goes into the bottom of that insert, and well, I should have showed you guys. Let me take it back off so you guys can see. You guys can see how it's wider around the end of those threads. That bolt actually bottoms out into this insert, okay? It's the same way on all of them. It's clearly how it was intended to be. Now you can tighten that down. Is this gonna bottom out and stop? There is no getting tighter than that because it realistically is just stuck on that insert. So that's that, it's installed. I'm gonna unload this kayak, obviously get the drive system in there. We're gonna go out there, we're gonna run into some of these super shallow points so you guys can see how this pops up, and then you can just push it back down and continue with your life. Obviously it is flexible. It's still very, very rigid, but it's flexible, so it'll pop up, pop out of the way. You can push it back in place and continue on. So let's get this kayak unloaded and then we'll go over there and we'll test it out. Okay, so we just pushed off the beach over here, rudder's down. We're gonna deploy this drive system. I always drop it in place. I use my left foot just to push it down, and then I snap this over. Now you can go all the way like this, or you can just leave it at that first click. That's up to you. I typically only go right here, and I've been doing that same thing using those locking knobs for, I guess, a really, really long time now, right? It'll flex, it'll hold it in place. You'll have no problems. It's not gonna move. Locked in good. You're not gonna have any water coming in between the drive or anything like that. What we're gonna do is we're just gonna come over here. I know these points are real, real shallow, and everyone's done this before. You're pedaling across the lake or a body of water, and you cut a corner, whether you're up north or you're in a place with a bunch of oyster bars, you're coming across this here point, and boom, you instantly stop. Take a second. We're gonna enjoy the beautiful morning sunrise out there behind those clouds, and then we're gonna be abruptly interrupted by this shallow sandbar, and we're going pretty good, okay? Whatever happens, happens. Okay, you see how it popped up, but it didn't break. That's our goal. It'll spin off of there, then you can just push that thing right back down. Now let's get out of here.
get to a little bit deeper water. Oops. Push that bad boy back down. You'll hear it click. It'll go back to being flush like that. Bring the drive back down. Push it in place. Lock it back in. And off you go. No big deal. All right. Now the first time we did it, it was like the little quarter lock to just one lock position. There's another point right here. This will have it all the way, pretty much all the way locked. Obviously we're going pretty quick again, putting off our wake. Holding onto this camera good so I don't drop it, that'd be funny. All right. Now that time we hit it hard enough that we popped it all the way off. Now it's not broke, right? That's the goal. The goal is it can come all the way off, not break. And realistically, we just pedaled into this point at 3.5 to 4 miles per hour. That's pretty impressive. That's the goal, okay? Now it's not broken, you're not stranded, your day is not ruined. All you gotta do is take that bad boy off of there. Don't drop it in the water, cause that'd be bad. And I'm doing it with one hand, so that's silly. Put that back in there. And then if you don't have your wrench, which you should, more often than not, you can just tighten it down with your hand like that temporarily. And if you keep spinning this like that, you see how you spun it? It'll tighten itself back down. You can do that with your stock one too. Oops, let's push off this shallow flat. Always nice to have these little shallow little points so you can run into them full speed on purpose. Obviously, you shouldn't be running into them full speed on purpose. Should be an accident. Boom, back in action. Like nothing ever happened. Off you go. Now, obviously, like we just said, you shouldn't be running into stuff on purpose. That's foolish. But that's going to stop you. If you live in a, or you fish a very, very wooded environment, lots of down trees, stuff like that. A lot of our customers are bass fishermen. Down here in the south, a lot of our customers fish around oyster bars, okay? Or super shallow, just sand flats. And you do run into stuff. And people break those, whether it's a rock wall, oyster wall, whatever, it happens, okay? And I know it happens because we sell a crazy amount of them on the website. Like, people buy them 5 at a time, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to put it on the website for $15, okay? It'll probably go to $20 shortly. We're going to put it on there for $15 and go from there. Obviously, like everything else, it has lifetime warranty. It's going to serve you well. Obviously, it'll be on all of my kayaks because, well, you saw, if you do have a problem, you can fix it with one hand in seconds, okay? You're not broken. You're not reaching in anything to get anything out of a box to fix it. And you're good to go. It should float, too. I should have tested that back there. I need to take it back off over there, show you guys if it floats or not. But it should float, okay? We'll see what happens with that. It should float. That should be pretty important. We'll figure that out here in a second. All right, we just pulled back into the launch over here. Moment of truth, remember this is still loose from us not tightening it down out there. If it did pop off because you hit too hard, I mean, I hit the first point pretty good, hit the second point real, real hard. If it does pop off like that, it should float. And there you have it, it floats. For some reason, if it does pop off and somehow it manages to get back into this hole. Well, there's no water there. But if there was water there, it floats, okay? Obviously, we've designed a bunch of parts in life, so the assumption of it floating holds true. If you guys have any questions, let me know. We had some requests for this. Nick, I break a lot of these knobs. How can we fix it, okay? So we designed a variation of this a very long time ago. We just really hadn't had time to talk about it or show you guys. Now that we have, we are going into the slower months of the year, so we have time to do more things. The next thing we'll talk about is how you install that anchor wizard in the chute without drilling any additional holes in your kayak and it's still functional. If you have questions, comments, anything, put them below. I'll put a link to this in the description. That's it. If you guys got questions, let me know. Thanks for watching.